Today I have a big cushion that I can hug on, and also I'm in pajamas. Also, I have a very big bottle with me to comfort me, and whew, let's talk about something that we haven't talked about yet. So recently I ended one of the biggest chapters in my life. I quit my job, I switched to a full-time YouTuber, and actually all I felt at that time was not being happy about it. It was more like feeling so empty and so lonely. I didn't accept that I was feeling down. I didn't admit that I was feeling down because I made my own decision and everyone's happy about it. Everyone's like looking up to me for that decision because I was brave enough to quit my job and do what I wanted to do. I felt like it was one of my responsibilities to not cry, not feel down, not being sad, and embrace the change, be happy about it, and make a good role model to anyone else who looks up to me. So I guess it was really challenging for me to accept that I was feeling down and it's okay not to be okay. I hid my feelings if it's something that's gonna hurt people, if it's something that's gonna worry my parents and my friends. I was really good at it. I used to hide my feelings and I used to not think about it. You know, I'm a happy person, I'm very independent. I would like to think that I'm mostly capable of doing everything by my own without anyone's help. I just have a big ego, I guess, and I think that kind of personality of mine kind of carried through my entire life up until now, and it's taken me a long, 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 long time to realize it's okay not to be okay. And there are people around you who are willing to help if you just say it. It's just really and literally one call away. I think nowadays a lot of people in this world, including me, think that they see that crying, feeling sad, or being sad as revealing one of your weaknesses and also even a failure to someone. But if you think about it, to voice that you are feeling down, to voice that you need help from someone else, and to cry to someone else, that requires a lot of courage, and I really respect that. Because I felt like, you know, I have a duty, I'm a very happy person. Like, depression or like feeling down is something that can't be in my territory or my personality, and a lot of people are watching me on YouTube and they are subscribed to me because maybe they felt like a very happy connection like between you and me. It was so hard for me to say that, hey, my life sucks and hey, my life is really crappy right now, would you like to join me for a drink and help me out? And I just kept all those feelings to my own and was struggling through everything, and I thought I'm gonna be okay because I'm so good at figuring out things, but I was literally wrong. I turned on the camera not because I'm really proud of myself who finally realized it's okay not to be okay. It's because I care about you guys, and I'm sure there's so many people like me who went through the depressing stages of your life and not saying out loud that you need help, and maybe even worse, they made a wrong decision by harming themselves. And I don't want any other people to suffer from the same thing, because it's okay not to be okay. It's okay to be sad. It's okay to cry in front of your friends or family or any strangers in public. It's okay. They're not gonna judge you. They're not gonna see that you are a failed person. It's just okay. Because I was there. I was really depressed. And if you take a moment and look around, there are so many people who actually care about you. So do take advantage of those friendship and relationship. I'm not talking about take advantage of that person, but I'm just saying take advantage of that friendship, because they are there to help you out. They are friends because they can share feelings, they can sympathize on what you are going through because they're your friends and they're your family. And I'm here for you if you think that helps. And I really care about you guys. I really love you. And I'm sure there are so many Korean students right now because it's right after the Korean big exam, like the SAT. That's a very small part of your life. It's okay if you screw them up. It's okay. I'm not sure how this video is gonna end, but I just wanted to say that I really love you guys. And 힘들어하지 마, 이거 보고 있으면.